name is Yahweh Shemasha, Hakaha, Hakaha, Hakaha. Glory to Yahweh Shemasha on the rehearsal of the Shabbat day. So today we're going into a very important prophetic chapter of the Bible, of the things that's getting ready to come upon the earth by the hand of the Most High Yahweh. So the opening scripture, brothers and sisters, we're going to go to today is in the book of Joel, chapter 2. It is written, it says, the day of the Lord. In the English, in Lashawan Kodash, it will say Yahweh. It says, blow ye the trumpet in Zion. So this is Zion. Regardless of what you heard, what they taught you in the seminary schools, what your mama said, what they say on TV, what the so-called Jews say, and the rest of these imitators and imposters say. The Most High told the disciples in Matthew chapter 10, verse 5 and 6, to go seek out the lost sheep of the house of Israel. So he said, go sound, blow the trumpet in Zion. The trumpet in ancient times gave off a certain sound. Like we use these horns back in ancient times. We blow them. And these horns gave our people understanding that the new moon was coming in, Shabbat was coming in, Feast of Tabernacles, or there were sounds for war to go in your house, get your weapons. The men had to report to the army, and the women and children had to go hide. So certain trumpets blew certain sounds in ancient times. Like today, we're blowing the trumpet of the Lord's word, Yahweh, in the Bible. So blow ye the trumpet in Zion, and sound an alarm in my holy mountain. The word holy means true, meaning the true people and the true mountain and new government that's coming in. In ancient times, we had it during the time of David and Solomon, and that was a mountain, Mount Zion. That's where the Most High had the law. He had the people of Israel under the covenant during the time of David and Solomon. That was the height of our kingdom. So he said, alarm in my holy mountain, and let all the inhabitants of the land tremble. Why did he say that? Because in the scriptures, people, the first thing to be accepted to the Most High is fear. Y'all were taught to love. The Most High said the first thing you have to do is fear him. See what it says here? Scriptures prove that. In the Apocrypha, Ecclesiastes chapter 19, and what? Verse 18. The fear of Yahweh is the first step to be accepted of him. See, when we blow this trumpet and we come in the name of Yahweh to our people, you know what our people think we are? A rap group. They call us the Isley Brothers back in the days. They call us names and they make mockery, like it says in Chronicles. They went through it, we're going to go through it also. Why y'all wearing a dress? This is not a dress, this is a robe. Why are you wearing them turbans on your head? You're Arab? No, we're Israelites. Israelites wore turbans. Tell you that in the law. That Bible was written by the white man. No, it was not. It was written by our forefathers and translating to this time in a stammer of another tongue so you can hear the trumpet when it's blown. So when we go to our people, they must fear the Most High, because what he's saying in this word is going to affect you. Fear of Yahweh is the first step to being accepted of him. And wisdom obtaineth his love. So when you obtain this knowledge of the Most High and the law and the testimony, that's his love. What they tell you in the church? Love the Lord. Love the Lord. Like we showed y'all earlier in our other series. The gods of this world are idols. The gods and doctrines of this world is made up by men. This knowledge in the Bible, which you're supposed to fear and reverence the Most High, comes from the heavens. And this is why a lot of our people don't have the fear of the Lord in them. That's why they're not acceptable right now. So when we come to our people, he said, blow the alarm, the holy, and my holy mountain, meaning the judgments written in the book. Isaiah says, seek ye out of the book of the Lord and read. None of these shall fail, not your one on me, people. And it says, let all inhabitants of the land tremble, because that's the first step to being accepted to them, by you fearing the Lord's word and fearing, trembling before him. For the day, there go again, of Yahweh cometh. It ain't here yet, but it's coming. And what the Most High told us in the Bible, I am a merciful power. So he's giving you time to get yourselves together. See? For it is nigh at hand. What type of day is coming, people? Maybe it's a day of flowers. Maybe it's a day of Geno Jenkins and all the rest of these false pastors, including the Edomites. Maybe everything they said is coming to pass. It says, no. A day of darkness and gloominess, a day of clouds and thick darkness. As the morning spread upon the mountains, a great people and a strong has been ever like. Neither shall there any more after, even in years of many generations. See that? A power, fire, devour before him. When the Lord returns to this earth, the earth is going to be on fire. Haven't we been telling y'all that out the Bible? What do you think Russia, America, China, East Indians, those East Indian people over there got atomic bombs, North Korea, and all the rest of them, Britain, France, Spain, all the NATO countries, most of them have atomic bombs, nuclear weapons. If two bombs destroyed Hiroshima and Nagasaki, and still today you go through there with a Geiger counter and people are dying from cancer, what do you think if these nations release all their weapons on each other? What kind of planet would this be for human existence? None. And that's why the Lord said, a fire devoured before them, and behind them a flame burneth. Precept. 2 Peter chapter 3. You mean the apostles wrote about destruction? It came with the love of Jesus. No, the apostles came with the love of Yahweh, and the fear of the Lord in them, and also with the love of the law in them, to warn our people that this day is coming and it's at hand. So you must tremble and humble yourself. Behold, the day, there you go again, of Yahweh will come as a thief in the night, in which the heavens shall pass away with a great noise. You see all this that you see out here in this world? One day, it's going to be on fire. And one day, it's going to be dissolved. And it says, in which the heavens shall pass away with a great noise. Boom! Thermonuclear bombs all over this planet. So when the Lord comes at that hour, he going to receive the remnant of Israel up into the flying chariots. That's how we're getting out of here. We're going to, the scriptures say, we're going to get out of here scarcely, maybe. He said, but what about the sinner and the non-believer? Where shall they be in that day? That's why you have to believe unto salvation. See? And it says, in which the heavens shall pass away with a great noise, and the elements shall melt with fervent heat, and the earth also, and the works that therein shall be burned up. See everything you see here? The Most High slated Esau for the most destructive part that he played as the wicked. And it ain't nothing nobody can do about it. We tell you Christian so-called ministers in Romans 9:13, the Lord hated Esau and he loved Jacob, and he said, what unrighteousness have you found in him? He made one born for honor and one boy for dishonor. What can you do against that? No, you know what you do? You blaspheme the Most High's word. You put what you want in the Bible. You say God love everybody and everybody gonna be saved. And that's a lie. Because that's not what Yahweh says in the book. When judgment comes, he said in the day of judgment, there is no mercy. See, once grace and judgment run, when the judgment comes, grace, everything gonna be gone. The fire is gonna come. See that? Same thing, right? That all these things shall be dissolved. See, that's why we ain't worried about no militia group. You're gonna go fight the white man. You're gonna go get a gun. Okay, the white man got tanks. He got armored carriers. He got Negroes in his army that'll kill you because you look like him. That don't mean that's your brother. He gonna kill you because they are on Satan's side. Then you gotta get past the state troopers. Then you gotta get past the police department. Then you gotta get past the army, the navy, air force, marines. We were sent here, people, because we broke the laws. And the Most High strengthened our enemies against us. That's why anytime you see when a Negro raised up with a gun in his hand, what they do to the Black Panthers? They killed all of them in their sleep. And before they died, and that was in my generation, we saw that back in the 70s. Eldridge Cleaver said, we underestimated the white man. You gonna kill the white man with a shotgun. You got a shotgun from Billy's gun shop. This man got an AR, we got an M16 with a 30 round clip. He got lasers that can see you, we got night vision. He got tanks, air guns, and he got a trained National Guard. This, even a National Guard would come to him with tanks and armored personnel. They will kill every militia group that's out there. All you gotta do is fly over you with a machine gun plane and shoot all you down in the woods and you'll fall out. So you're not getting out of here to no militarism. The Halabah Shema Shah saves. And if you turn from that and you turn back to the Most High and put down your weapons, like he said, our weapons are warfare, spiritual, not carnal. This is how we get out of here. We get out of here through faith and through works and through his mercy. So in these last days, he said, blow the trumpet and let all the inhabitants of our people that's listening hear this truth. Because he said, what? A man of persons ought ye to be in this time. In all holy conversation and your holiness. Meaning, what are you supposed to be talking about? The scriptures. What are you supposed to be setting yourself up to do? Get ready to come to class. What are you supposed to be setting yourself up to do? Conforming from this world by the renewing of your mind. Why? Because something get ready to go down in the Most High's works and his plans. Just like in ancient times when we told you last week. When the Most High took down ancient Babylon. Let's go back to that story and add a scripture to this to show you the proof. Let's go to Daniel chapter 5. When the Babylonians were ruling, which are the Cushites, like we showed you in the series last week, the Babylonians came to their height of their power. There was an arrogant king they called Nebuchadnezzar. Arrogant Hamite. Them people are still like that today. Daniel 5:25. And in this chapter, the Lord was telling his son, he was like, Belshazzar, your father, Nebuchadnezzar, I warned you about him, and you just like him. You just as proud and arrogant and lifted up as you want to be. So therefore, the Most High brought judgment upon the Babylonians. See? And this is a writing that was written many, many Tekel Yoshuites. And this is the interpretation of the thing. Many, Yahweh has numbered thy kingdom and finished it. Tekel, thou art weighed in the balance and art found wanting. Peres, the kingdom is divided and given to the Medes and Persians. Y'all hear that? So at that time, when the Most High was going to take down Babylon, the first Babylon, the ancient Babylon, he put the inscription on the wall. And he put it up there in the air, and the son of Nebuchadnezzar looked up and he saw the hand writing. And Daniel told him the interpretation. Now, we're going to do the same thing to America. The handwriting is on the wall. And what is it? You will find out in a few minutes. See what it says? Then commanded Belshazzar, and they clothed Daniel with scarlet, and put a chain of gold on his neck, and made a proclamation concerning him that he should be third ruler in the kingdom. So because he was dealing with the knowledge of the Most High, not the Babylonians, they gave him his promise. Like we get our benefits here in this nation because of the Most High. It ain't because of the white man. It's because of Yahweh Bashemah Shah. And get on your knees and thank him for your benefits. See? As it says in Psalms 103 and Psalms 105. And it says here, verse 30. And that night was Belshazzar, the king of the Chaldeans, slain. You hear that? He got killed. And Darius the Median took the kingdom, being about 62 years old. So as the father told the Babylonians, you're going down. Now we got a new Babylon. Let's go to Psalms 137 again, verse 7 and 8. Precept, line upon line. Now we got a new Babylon. That was ancient Babylon ran by the Kushites. Now we got a new one called what? Remember, O Yahweh, the children of Edom. Remember that word Edom? What it means? It means in our language, Gabaya, red. When Babylon destroyed Jerusalem, the Edomites were our servants underneath us. They said, tear it down, tear it down. Yay! They probably had a baseball game back then with frankfurters and cotton candy. They were cheering that we would fall like they do today. You see how they be celebrating things? What are they going back to? As soon as the plague starts easing up, let's go back to Halloween. Let's get the baseball game going on. Let's get Aladdin going on. They went back in there and everybody got sick. And they shut it down. Because the Most High shut it down. That's what he want to do. He said in Revelation, there ain't going to be no more joy and music. And it's whore anymore. See? And it says what? In 137 verse 7. Remember, Gabaya, meaning Edom. In the day of Jerusalem. Who said, raise it even to the foundation thereof. O daughter of Babylon. This is how you prove that the Edomites took on the customs of ancient Babylon. That's why they celebrate Christmas. You see them on TV now talking about we got a shortage of Christmas trees. What month is this? They're getting ready to make money already off the populace. So they're going to show you they have repented from their sorcery and their deeds. As it says in Mark 7 and 7, they don't keep the commandments. They keep the what? Traditions of men. That's what you got going on here in the daughter of Babylon. Who ought to be what? Destroyed. Happy shall you be that reward of thee as thou hast served us. The day of reckoning is coming, people. Reap what you sow, Galatians 6 and 7. He that leadeth into captivity shall go into captivity. He that killeth with the sword must be killed with the sword. Revelation 13, 9 and 10. Isaiah 14. We're going to take them captives whose captives we were. And we're going to rule over our oppressors. That's righteous judgment. It wouldn't be right if the Most High didn't do that to them for what they did to us. See? Happy shall you be and take up and dash with thy little ones against the stones. That means it's going to be a revolution. And people are going to die. And people are going to get killed. And people are going to be crying and weeping. Why? Because he said in Isaiah 47, verse 1. Let's go there real quick. Talk about the virgin daughter of Babylon. He said, Yahweh's judgment upon Babylon. Is this ancient Babylon? Let's see if it is. Come and sit down in the dust, O virgin daughter of Babylon. No, this ain't talking about the land of the Kushites, the Babylonian battle place that was over there in the east back then. It's not talking about them. is talking about who? These so-called Americans. These so-called whites. Who have taken all these customs. Gabbaya read in Psalms 137, 7 and 8 is talking about Esau. Harry. See? And it says here, sit on the ground. And there's no throne, O daughter of the Chaldeans. Daughter of the Chaldeans. You ever wondered why you got a Statue of Liberty in the Bay? You ever wondered why did the Roman Church and the rest of these churches push women images in the world? Because they got the same thing from Ceramicus, the deprived queen of heaven. They practice that here. They practice woman worship in the Mother Mary, and that's Nimrod and Ceramicus. Images that you see in the Roman church with the woman and the little baby. And the blasphemies of Immaculate Conception. All of that goes back to these ancient whorish nations. But thou shalt no more be called tender and delicate. America ain't gonna be tender and delicate no more. Why? Because there was never a world war on this land. They had a revolution, the Civil War, but they never had a war on this land. So they ain't gonna be tender and delicate no more. Why? Take the millstone and grind the mill. Uncover the locks. Bare the legs and uncover thy thigh and pass over the rivers. So right now, the Roman church, the influences all over the planet of them raping. Listen. Raping little boys. And the Roman church has hit the French Catholic Church, Spanish Catholic Church, American Catholic churches was established on this. And they got this thing going on coast to coast, people. Look at all these priests and all these reports on these devils. Rapers. Little Boy Scouts got raped. Remember the Boy Scouts when you were a little kid? Everybody wanted to be a Boy Scout. They were being raped and sodomized by the counselors. And the girls. Why do you think all these sisters that go to Catholic school end up with the white man? Mm-hmm. Huh? It's a slave religion and a slave camp. They indoctrinated us, they plundered us, they took the men, turned them into faggots, and broke up the families. That's why there's no family order. Because of this virgin daughter of Babylon who has influenced the whole world. And they said that Jehovah's Witnesses and all white church systems worldwide got reports on them raping the world. They raped the Polynesians. Go talk to them, they'll tell you. They raped the people down there in Brazil. They raped Ham, and they still continue to rape them women and eat. Australia, those Aborigines, their land was taken by the British. Rape, robbery, and murder all throughout the East and these islands by white people who claim to be the children of God. Didn't they say they were the children of God? That's what they said. But were they? No. And it says here, and bear the leg. Their women used to wear, remember them white women? Go watch that, what's that show? Little House on the Prairie. Remember your own House on the Prairie? You see those white women with their long dresses, and they used to be in the church, and they used to be like, telling on the mountain, and they had a Negro slave. Your behind was in the barn while they were inside the church. Then they came in the barn and taught you their religion that they got out of their little farm churches, and that's why you got the colonial Negro today in the neighborhood praying on white Jesus. They gave it to us. And then women used to wear the long dresses. Now you see the white woman walking around with a suit on. Now she's a lesbian. Now she's liberated. She go around thinking she a man. She got a job, CEO of a company, and here's a Negro. You've been there over 400 years, and you sweeping the floor. This is what you want. This is freedom for us, huh? And our women have compassed us. Yeah. They're out there with the white man in corporate America, laying with him as a big wench, modern day. Don't tell us about no integration and making no progress. This is captivity according to this Bible, and the bearing of the legs is all over the world right now for these freaky people. See what it says? Take the millstone and grind the mill and uncover the locks and bear the lake. Uncover the thigh, pass over the rivers, and that's where they at now. Even over there in Iraq, where they ran their butts out of there. Biden Saigon, that's what they call it. They went over there and had influence to their women, the Arabic women of the East, because they all practice a pagan religion called Islam. And they wanted their women not to drive cars, not to go to school, not to uncover their bodies. Now that America's went over there, the women are coming out saying, we want equal rights. We are equal to the men, and the men are standing there with a machine gun in that woman, shut your mouth. The camera's watching. Shut your mouth, and when that camera goes off, bam! And they hang their behinds up in the street somewhere. Because that's not what they do. But America has influenced the women to come out of the bag on their men over there. What you think they did to the 12 tribes of Israel? Why do you think their woman is out of order? Because of these damn devils. And they're a worldwide conspiracy to teach blasphemies worldwide. Everybody's influenced and touched by these damn people. See? Thy nakedness shall be uncovered. Here you go again. What are they doing in the church? America's worst sex abuse churches. This is real. The Pope is a dope. Mm-hmm. He's a pervert. Right. And you've been going in the Catholic Church praying to the devil. Let me show you some of these reports. Here you go right here. Diocese in Tucson, Arizona. Y'all know where Arizona is? 34 accused priests, 34 of them, 22 victims. Defunct priest Kevin